I'm Jackie with the Water Conservation Office. Join me now on a wondrous journey to one of the most magical places in all of Athens. Welcome to the Water Reclamation Facility. What happens here is a miracle of nature with a little helping hand from science and engineering. We all use water every day to keep us clean and healthy. We wash dishes, we take a shower, and we flush a toilet. But have you ever thought about what happens to that water when it goes down the drain? Well, all that water needs to be cleaned before it's returned to nature. Athens has three water reclamation facilities where we turn collected water like this into reclaimed water like this. It takes a lot of steps, some serious machinery, and an army of little tiny workers to transform our used water. Let's take a closer look at how that magic happens. The water flushed from homes, buildings, and businesses throughout Athens travels through our sanitary sewer system and arrives at the INFLUENT pumps. The pumps force the water up to higher elevation at this building called Headworks. And from there, we let gravity do the work to move our collected water through the rest of the process. Yeah, gravity! Ah! At the Headworks building, the collected water moves past a band screen to remove all kinds of floating solid debris. No, not the solids you were thinking about, but plastics, trash, and other items that could damage the machinery. This trash is removed from the water, ground up, compacted, and dumped in a collection box. So, look at this and think about what you put down the toilet. Next, the water moves into a grit removal system. Here, simple laws of physics are used to remove heavier solids like gravel and sand and grit. When the collection boxes are full, they are trucked to the landfill. Fun fact, the Headworks building can get a little smelly. To reduce that unpleasant odor, we pull in the air through overhead pipes and filter it through activated carbon, so the folks that work here, as well as our neighbors, don't have to breathe stink all day. It still doesn't smell like freshly baked cookies in here, but it's not too bad. Want one? The screenings done at the Headworks are very effective and remove almost 50% of pollutants, but we still have a lot of cleaning to do. For this next step, we harness the power of nature's hungriest little buggers to help us clean our water. But first, a drop quiz, just to see if you're keeping up. Can the water collected from our homes, buildings, and businesses ever be used again? A, no, the water we collect from homes, buildings, and businesses magically disappears. B, no, the water we collect can never be used again because it is too dirty. C, yes, but the water we collect can only be used in swimming pools for mutant alligators. D, yes, the water we collect can be recycled and used again after thorough water treatments have been performed. Pause now to discuss. Okay, ready? The answer is D. Yes, the water we collect can be recycled and used again after thorough water treatments have been performed. Now, let's get back to the action. These big tanks are called aeration basins, and they hold a million gallons of water each. You can't see them swimming in here, but these tanks are filled with billions of microorganisms. The same microorganisms we use for reclaiming water are found in nature. They live in our lakes, creeks, and streams, and they feed in those environments. But here at the Water Reclamation Facility, we've set up an all-you-can-eat buffet. There's some serious bioscience going on in here, but basically what's happening is we're creating an environment where bacteria or microscopic little bugs eat away all the compounds and other stuff we don't want in the water. By controlling the oxygen in these tanks, we stimulate the bacteria, rotifers, protozoans, water bears, and other organisms to feed and reproduce. Through this biological process, the microorganisms help to clean our water just as they do in nature. When you have the right quantity of decomposers for the right purpose, these microorganisms are very beneficial. We want to keep things like ammonia, phosphorus, and nitrogen out of our water sources. And these hungry little helpers make that happen. Once the bugs have done their job, it's time to remove them from the water. This happens in the clarifying basins. The microorganisms clump together and form flock. Sometimes we add a chemical called alum to help the microorganisms clump together, but most of the time, they do it on their own. As the flock becomes heavier, it sinks to the bottom of the basin. At the top of the clarifying basin, we have clear water. And in the bottom of the basin is the collected flock called sludge. It's kind of like the salad dressing. When it's all stirred up, the herbs and spices are mixed evenly throughout the liquid. Once we let the dressing sit for a while, all that solid material sinks to the bottom. That's basically what's happening in this big tank. The solid material, called sludge, sinks to the bottom. The sludge is then scraped from the bottom with a huge, slowly spinning mechanism. This sludge contains our useful bacteria, so sometimes we return it to the aeration basins to feed again. Other times, this sludge is headed here to the dewatering building. Whoa, let's put the brakes on right there because it's time for another drop quiz. Which of these statements about microorganisms is false? A, microorganisms are living organisms that are so small you need a microscope to see them. B, microorganisms can be beneficial to a water reclamation facility. C, microorganisms were created using microchip technology. D, microorganisms can be found naturally in lakes, creeks, and streams. Pause now to discuss. Okay, ready? The answer is C. Microorganisms are not created using microchip technology. And now, back to the water reclamation facility. In the dewatering building, the sludge from the clarifying basins enters a centrifuge. A centri- what? Similar to how a washing machine on the rinse cycle spins around to remove water from your clothes, the centrifuge spins the sludge at high speeds to remove the water. The dried material that comes out is called biosolids. From here, the biosolids can be transported to an area at the landfill where they are mixed with leaf and limb material to generate compost that can be used as fertilizer to help plants and trees grow. After the clarifying basins, our water moves to the final stage in the treatment process, and it's pretty intense. We're talking ultraviolet light disinfection. Whoa! You can't see them, but inside these channels are rows of super powerful UV light bulbs. UV stands for ultraviolet. This strong ultraviolet light penetrates the cell wall of any remaining organisms, destroying its ability to reproduce. All along the treatment process, we grab samples of the water and perform numerous tests every day in our lab to be sure the water meets the standards set by our state and federal government. Once we know the water is free from harmful bacteria and viruses, it's ready to return to nature. After UV treatment, our water flows over a series of steps. This movement adds oxygen back to the water. From the steps, the water travels through a long pipe and is returned to the river, where it continues along the never-ending water cycle. The treatments we've performed to recycle this water have made it safe for the environment. And that is a beautiful thing. Now that you've seen all the work it takes to recycle our water, we need your help to make the job easier and protect our treatment system. The number one thing is to never throw trash in the toilet, because this is what happens. Ugh. Take a good look, because this nightmare is known in the water biz as a mop head, and that's the nicest thing you could call it. It's a huge, heavy blob of trash, wipes, paper towels, rags, and other junk that gums up our equipment and clogs our pipes. Yuck! No one wants to see this, no one can forget it, but it can be easily avoided. Just remember the four P's of flushing. Only pee, poo, paper, and puke should go down the toilet. Let me repeat that in slow motion. If it's not one of the four P's, it should go in the trash can or recycling bin, not the toilet. Time for one more drop quiz. Yes or no? Should you ever flush flushable wipes down the toilet? Pause now to discuss. Okay, ready? No, it doesn't start with a P. All wipes, be it baby wipes, disinfecting wipes, and even flushable wipes, are not flushable. Remember, wipes clog pipes. Toss them in the trash. Whatever goes down the drain comes to our facility. Keep fats, oils, and grease, fog, out of the drain. Put fog and food scraps in the trash, or recycling, or compost if you can. Please do your part and follow these tips to protect your home's plumbing, our sewer system, the environment, and our water. We hope you've learned a little about the miracle of water reclamation. Thanks for watching and happy flushing!